Welcome to The Abyss. I'm Jacqueline, and today we're answering the question, why the ocean is salty. Let's dive in. At its most basic level, the ocean is salty because one of the properties of water is that it is great at dissolving material, and in particular, salt. This can be easily demonstrated by stirring table salt into a glass of water. The ions in the salt molecules bond with the water molecules dissolving the salts. This is in contrast to water insoluble compounds such as sand. When the sand is stirred into the water, no bonds are formed. Therefore, the sand sinks to the bottom. Without this property, that salt is soluble in water, any of the salts that entered the water would sink to the bottom. This explains why the water can be salty, but not where the salts come from. Most of the ocean's salts come from rivers and the weathering of the continents. Salt is naturally found on the Earth's surface in a crystalline structure. When it rains, some of these salts get dissolved into the water. The water then runs off into rivers and makes its way into the ocean. In this form, the salt is in a very low concentration. The water in the ocean then evaporates, leaving the salts behind and starting this whole cycle over again. Over time, the salt level in the ocean builds up into a higher concentration, making the water salty. This is the main source of salt in the ocean, but some salts and other trace elements enter the ocean through the Earth's interior. This includes sources such as hydrothermal vents and underwater volcanoes. As well as being constantly added to the ocean, salt is being used up by chemical and biological processes. Over time, this adding and removing of salt has reached a steady state, where the salinity remains relatively constant. In fact, the ocean has been at its current salinity for several hundred million years. On average, the salinity of the ocean is 3.5%, which is expressed as 35 parts per thousand. Salt is a term used to describe a certain kind of compound that is composed of two oppositely charged ions. The salt in the ocean is made up of many different ions that are found in different concentrations based on the rate they are used up. For example, sodium is used up very slowly, so it is found in a high concentration. On the other hand, calcium and silicone are used in the construction of shells. Therefore, they're used up very rapidly and found in a low concentration. One interesting thing about the concentration of these ions is that their proportion remains constant. This is because the ocean fully mixes as the ions are being used up. This is a useful property for scientists because for many years, this was how salinity was measured. You can calculate the concentration of one ion, usually chloride or sodium, because they are found in the highest concentrations, and use this to determine the concentrations of the rest of the ions and the total salinity. The six main ions that are found in the ocean are chloride, sodium, sulfate, magnesium, calcium, and potassium. Together, they make up 99.6% of the total salt. Although the proportion of ions remains constant, the total salinity can vary. It ranges from about 32 parts per thousand at the low end to 37 parts per thousand at the high. It varies due to factors such as climate and the input of water. On a local scale, salinity varies at river mouths where fresh water enters the ocean, resulting in a lower salinity. This water quickly mixes with the ocean water and returns to normal within a few kilometers. On a larger scale and in the open ocean, salinity varies in areas where evaporation and precipitation are higher than normal. For example, the Mediterranean Sea has a high salinity. This is because it is an area with a hot, dry climate and high evaporation. And that is why the ocean is salty. If you have any other questions about the ocean, leave them in the comments down below. If you liked this video, remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, I will see you later.